Are you a fan of horror stories? You know, the ones that help you experience those thrilling moments of scare and fear that at some point of a time making it so exciting and enticing, and the story that just grips you out of this reality to experience the adrenaline and horror that other characters are going through. Well, I'm usually not this kind of person. I honestly don't really like horror films or just horror as a genre, especially given the fact that in a lot of times it becomes something just a compilation of jump scares with great makeup or CGI, and thus there is no more good suspense in it, you know? So I was really skeptical when I got a suggestion and decided to try out to watch The Haunting of Bly Manor, which turned out to be a great story. So let's see what it's all about. I'll try to do no spoilers, but I will really touch upon a little bit of the beginning of the plot just for you to understand the context. So it all starts at a wedding where people are celebrating and having a great event where they're of course toasting and talking all the great things, but then after the dinner, the official, I think it was a rehearsal, they're all meeting next to the fireplace, and one of the guests decides to tell a story about love. To give more of an understanding of how it looks like, it's more like the gothic romance, as I once saw people describing this whole thing. It all starts in the 80s, and the main character, the main hero of the story, is a lady coming from the America, from the United States, and she is looking to apply for a job as an au pair at one of the wealthy men in Britain, and basically she would need to take care of his niece and nephew in a quite a beautiful estate called Bly Manor. There were some mysterious things happening around in the interview, while also was going normal. At the end of the day, they are meeting each other at the bar, and after this they tried to talk more honestly, and they agreed that Danny, who is the main character, will take the job, and thus she's going to Bly. This is the place where the whole story going to unveil, and all of the more weird things gonna pop in every now and then, and especially given the fact that main antagonist, if you put it this way, is the ghost that's living somewhere around, but also there's something wrong with the kids as well, and Flora and Miles sometimes acting incredibly strange. Even though, as Flora would say, everything is perfectly splendid, most of the times something really weird is happening. And Danny's seeing things around. But you know, what I really liked, the way they built the film, and I didn't watch the first series of Haunting of Hill House, they were able to make you feel that for most of the things that are seeming weird and that you don't go into the explanation that someone is possessed, or there is a ghost, or there is something else, you most of the times will try to describe it more like, yeah, okay, kids, they have trauma because of this unfortunate event happening to their parents, and then Donnie was first seeing things, but then there was a good explanation why it may have happened. So up until middle of the whole series, it maybe seemed more or less realistic what is happening around. And you know, that's what I really liked about it, and it kept me gripped with the strong fist of the story. And then this happened. So, like, of course, the story needed to move on, and all these weird things, they were not just happening without the reason, and it all started to move from something awkwardly realistic to the point where it all started to look like some sort of a fairy tale. Let's put it this way. And I know that may seem like a spoiler because now you wouldn't take the things more seriously, but I guess I also wasn't really taking them as such after episode 5, I think. And especially authors, they really killing you with the sequential disorder they're creating, with the different timelines being intertwined and you're moving from one character to the other, seeing their different memories, and then some of those who were not even part of those memories also entering there, and then with whose eyes you're even seeing of what is going on. And that gives you a bit of an awkward moment when you're sometimes just being a bit stuck in trying to understand what is actually going on. But of course, as much as you're trying to go further and further, learning more facts, and you're trying to get exactly what is going on, at some point of time, I think a bit more of a disappointing, yet really nice, was the ending. And the penultimate episode was explaining what is happening in the manor. Like, was there a curse? What was the cause of these ghostly things happening around? And who are all those people? And where is the missing ones? And did people die by themselves? Or did someone make them? You know, it all continued to be describes, and I really liked that. I felt even emotional in the very last episode when the whole story was ending, and they were really pressing you to like feel that the things that are happening and the way the story concludes is actually really nice and cute and soft and warm, you know, even though some dramatic event at the end still happened. But just by seeing how this all came to conclusion, that's when I got this feeling of a fairy tale. That's the whole story was really suitable for the wedding. So yeah, I definitely enjoyed what was going around in the Haunting of Bly Manor, and I hope you guys also did. Or if you haven't yet watched the series, I hope you will find some time to go for all 9 episodes. It's not that long. Probably it is. If I would calculate right now, it's like 40 minutes each, 45 minutes each, 9 academic hours. Okay, yeah, it's pretty long, but it may take you just one day to binge watch, so I guess it's okay. If you really have a free day and you don't know what to do during our new lockdown times, you know what you should. Netflix for the savior. Thank you guys. Give a like, subscribe and comment, and I hope to listen from you about your experiences of Haunting of Bly Manor, and I'll see you next time.